In this video, I'm going to sketch the graphs of more complicated polar equations, and we're going to identify the values of theta which make exactly, basically the range of theta that makes exactly one copy of the graph. And also we're going to identify angles theta where the radius is zero. Okay, so the first example is going to be to sketch R is equal to, well, let me enumerate it. So R is equal to cosine 2 theta. So you might think it might be a circle graph, but it wouldn't be because of this 2. You see, whenever you have a number like this, which is not 1, multiplying the angle, then you know for sure it's not going to be a circle. It's going to be some kind of distorted curve. Okay? But let's see what it is. So I'm going to draw the xy plane, which is also a polar graph. Okay. So this is x, this is y. Okay. And for this particular example, what we're going to do, we're going to draw we're just going to draw lines for pi over 4. And we're going to draw lines for 3 pi over 4 theta. Okay. So now let's analyze this. So we have to input the angles theta and then analyze what the values are going to be. So angle theta is equal to 0. What's going to happen to the r? R is equal to cosine of 2 times 0, right? So cosine of 2 times 0 is cosine of 0, which is 1, right? So at the angle theta, the value is 1. We might as well use something lighter, maybe like this. So the value is 1. Now let's take a look at the next one. Let's take a look at pi over 4 angle, right? Because this guy is pi over 4. And this is the reason why I drew this line, is because of this 2. You see, if it multiplies pi over 4, it becomes pi over 2. Right? So let's check pi over 4. So r is equal to cosine 2 times pi over 4. And that gives you cosine of pi over 2, which is equal to 0, right? So what happens? We're back at 0. Well, we were never there, but this is the origin, right? So it looks like we're curving like this and we're coming here, right? Okay, so far this is what we have of the curve. Okay, so now let's keep going. Theta is equal to pi over 2. Let's see what happens with the radius. So by the way, already the radius is 0 at pi over 4. So we can say radius 0 at pi over 4. Okay. So now cosine of 2 pi over 2, right? 2 times pi over 2, which is cosine of pi, right? Cosine of pi is equal to negative 1. So this is where we got to be careful. So so cosine of pi is negative 1, but the angle you are checking is pi over 2, right? So we're talking about the y-axis, but it says that the radius is negative. Okay? And since the radius is negative, we cannot stay at pi over 2, the positive y-axis, we have to go half, we have to go pi radians across, right? So we have to go downstairs instead of going upstairs from the origin. So we have to go here, okay, at the negative 1. And this is only true when the radius is negative. So whenever it's negative, you just go half, you just go pi radians in the opposite direction. Okay, so in this case, we were in the positive y-axis, but we go in the opposite direction, so we're at the negative 1 instead of the 1. Okay, let's keep going. So theta is equal to pi, 3 pi over 4, right? That's the next one, because we're going by the increments of pi over 4. So we're now here. So r is equal to cosine of 2 times 3 pi over 4. And that is equal to cosine of 3 pi over 2. Cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0. Right, so we're back at the origin for this angle, for 3 pi over 2. 3 pi over 4, sorry. So we're back at the origin. So once again, radius is equal to 0 at 3 pi over 4. So we can put it down. We'll make a rule afterwards, right? So right now, it looks like we can already make the rule. So it looks like pi over 4, 3 pi over 4. So basically what separates it is odd values of pi over 4, right? So we can make a rule as to, let's say, n pi over 4, right? And n odd integer. So we can already make the rule, right? N odd integers. So it means that if n is 1, we'll have pi over 4. If n is 3, the next odd integer will have 3 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4, etc., etc., right? So this is a rule. So radius is 0, is 0 at those theta values, okay? But let's keep going, because we have to create the full graph, right? Full one copy of the graph. Right now it seems incomplete, so let's keep going. Theta is equal to pi. That's the next one. That's going to be the negative x-axis, right? R is equal to cosine of 2 pi. Cosine of 2 pi is 1, right? So this is where you should not be confused. Even though it says 1, but it's non-negative, first of all, and we are at the pi, right, for the theta. So we have to be loyal to that negative x-axis. We have to remain at that pi, since the radius is non-negative. Right, so don't be confused because it says 1. You might think, oh, but why are we not going to here to the 1 and we're going to the negative 1? Well, because we have to stay loyal to the angle theta, since the radius is non-negative, right? If it were negative, then we would go back to the 1. But we have to be here. Okay, so we have to go here. Okay. So notice where this is all going. It looks like we're going to probably draw, complete these leaves, basically. And there will be, looks like, 4 leaves. 1, 2, 3, and 4. But we're not sure what the range of theta will be for completion of these leaves, right? So we have to keep going to check, right? So then theta is equal to 5 pi over 4. We know the radius will be 0 based on our observation earlier, right? Based on the rule. So radius is going to be equal to, let's just check it, 5 pi over 2. Cosine of 5 pi over 2 is the same as cosine of pi over 2. That's 0. Great. So our observation, our rule works. So it has to be 0. Notice it makes sense, because we're completing this leaf and we're traveling back to the origin, right? Okay. So now you know what, I'm gonna skip this work, because I'm gonna find a pattern here. So at the next one, 3 pi over 2 theta, let's see, where was it 0 before? So 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1, 0. So that means the radius is gonna be negative 1 there at 3 pi over 2. And that makes sense, because if it's negative, we cannot be loyal to that angle 3 pi over 2. We have to go in the opposite direction, which is pi over 2, right? So it makes sense that we go up there, because that's the next leaf, right, that we must complete. Makes total sense. Let's keep going. So what's the next one? 6 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4, right? Radius should be theoretically 0 and should match the rule we've made, right? That it's 0 for the odd integers of n, right? So, and let's see, cosine of 7 pi over 2. That's cosine of negative pi over 2. cosine of negative pi over 2 is 0. Great, yeah, it should be 0, right? So we're going back to the origin, right? So we're all, so one more leaf left to complete, and then we're done. We've produced one full copy of the graph, right? So let's just check it one more time. Theta is equal to 8 pi over 4, which is 2 pi, right? So the radius should be theoretically cosine of 4 pi is the same as cosine of 2 pi is 1, right? And let's see if it makes sense with the pattern. Negative 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1. Great. It does make sense, and it makes sense with the graph. So we're back at the starting point. So that's a one full copy of the graph, four leaves in there, right? So the range that we're looking for is from 0, the range of theta, right, for one full copy of the graph, from 0 to 2 pi. All right, range of theta for one full copy of the graph. Okay, so now let's try one more example. So in this example, the graph is going to be r is equal to 2 cosine theta minus pi over 4. Okay, so notice right away, since you're not multiplying the theta with an integer other than 1, you're just shifting it, right? This is a shift. This is a shift, phase shift. You definitely know that you're going to have a circle. This is the equation of the circle. But it's not going to be centered at the origin, okay? So this shift will probably shift the circle somehow, but we're going to find out about it, right? Let's draw this in the xy plane. And then we'll test the theta values as we did in the first example. So we have x, we have y. Okay, so let's see. So based on the amplitude 2, we have to draw 2 ticks for each axis. Okay, just in case. Okay, so let's see. Let's test the values. So, and once again, we're going to determine the range for one full copy of the graph, and also we're going to determine the angle theta measures which yield the radius 0. Right, so let's try. Theta is equal to 0. Right? The starting point for theta. R is equal to 2 cosine. 0 minus pi over 4 is negative pi over 4. Cosine of negative pi over 4 is the same as cosine of pi over 4 because it's an even function. And once again, let me draw the the pi over 4 lines and 3 pi over 4 lines. We need that again. Okay. Just in case. Okay. So these are pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4 lines. Theta, basically. Okay. So cosine of negative pi over 4 is radical 2 over 2. Multiply that by 2, you get radical 2. Okay. So at angle theta 0, it's radical 2 for the radius, and that's the distance from the origin, right? The radius is always the distance from the origin. So we can put it, radical 2 is probably, it's just a little bit greater than 1, right? It's not in the middle between 1 and 2, but it's somewhere right there, right? So we can put it up there. Okay, so now let's keep going. And remember, we decided that was a circle, based on the equation here. Okay, so now next theta is pi over 4. And once again, why did I decide to draw these blue lines for pi over 4 increments? Because we have a subtraction of negative pi over 4. This tells me that we should have these. Okay, so the r value is equal to pi over 4 minus pi over 4 is 2 cosine of 0, and that's equal to 2. Okay, so that at that angle pi over 4, we have 2 as the distance. Okay, so probably something like that. This is the distance of 2. Okay, now next one is going to be pi over 2. So the radius there, by the way, notice that radius is 0 at is 0 at theta is equal to where? Well, we didn't have the 0 yet, right? We need to get there. Okay, but we're gonna get there. So pi over 2 cosine 2 cosine of pi over 2 minus pi over 4 is pi over 4, and that's the same thing as this result, right? Because it's an even function, so that means it's radical 2. So at angle theta of pi over 2, it's radical 2. So it's the same distance from the origin that was on the positive x-axis, now it's going to be on the y-axis, right? Okay, and guess what? I probably didn't draw this 2 correctly. It should be exactly equidistant. It should be, 2 should be probably a little higher, right? Well, let's see. Because if we use the Pythagorean theorem, we will understand that squaring radical 2 plus radical 2 will give us 2 plus 2, which is radical 4, which is equal to 2. Right? So it means that that this is a hypotenuse, and this should be at greater length. Okay? Well, it's not the best picture, but you know what? I should just in case move it to see that it makes complete sense. Okay, so I'm just gonna move it like somewhere here. Okay, that, and also that makes complete sense with this, the fact that we're talking about a circle. Let's see, and I'm gonna need to connect this blue line again. Okay, should be a lighter color. Okay, something like that. Okay, in any case, next one. Pi over 4, right? Because we're going in pi over 4 increments. So radius is equal to 2 cosine. 3 pi over 4 minus pi over 4 is exactly 2 pi over 4, which is pi over 2, right? That's 0. Okay, so we're at the origin, right? We're here. So it looks like it's one full copy of the graph, right? Because we started here, but we need one more theta for that, just to confirm. 3 pi over 4, the next one is pi, right? The radius at pi is 2 cosine of pi minus pi over 4 is 3 pi over 4. 3 pi over 4 cosine is negative radical 2 over 2, so multiply that by 2 is negative radical 2. Since it's negative, we can't stay at the pi angle, we have to go in the opposite direction, so we have to wind up at this beginning point. So that makes complete sense that it's a full graph, right? So we can connect it, making sure that it's a circle. Well, maybe I should draw a better one. No, it should not touch, should not go beyond this line. Something like that. Well, maybe I should use a circle like that. Yeah, maybe that's better. Yeah. Well, maybe a little higher. Something like that, right? It's not going to be the best circle, but you definitely know that this is a full copy of the graph. So now let's determine the range. So the range range for one full copy is, let's see, from 0 to, where did we stop? Pi, right? 0 to pi. Okay, from 0 to pi. Now, where's the radius 0? Where was it 0? It was at 3 pi over 4. And then, well, let's see. It was 0 at 3 pi over 4, so we had to go 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3, so 1, 2. Well, actually, we needed to go, so each time we have to go 4 times, 4 increments of pi over 4 in order to repeat the same value for the radius, right? Well, for the same point to be repeated, right? For the same point in the circle. So that means we have to add pi all the time. So 3 pi over 4 plus pi is 7 pi over 4, etc. etc. So how do we make a rule? So theta is going to be equal to 3 pi over 4 plus n pi, right? N integer. So that makes sense, because if n is equal to 1, then the next one, if n is equal to 0, it's just going to be 3 pi over 4. If n is equal to 1, it's going to be 7 pi over 4, and etc., etc. So this rule makes complete sense. Okay, so I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel if you want, and I'll see you in my next video.